Hello and welcome. In this video I will show you how to observe and change field values. We have player and health bar. Let's make controllers with them. Important disclaimer. Some of the things shown in this video are not present in the editor out of the box, and are added by the ultimate editor enhancer asset. I'm just so used to them that I'm not ready to stop using it even for another assets video. This has no effect on the value observer features shown, so I don't see the point of downgrading to the built-in editor features. Okay. We have a health field. We want to observe its value, pass its value to other components, and validate it. This is usually done in one of several ways. Without checking at all. Or by checking for changes to the value in update. Or by implementing properties or methods to get and set the value. Or by implementing your own observer pattern. All of these ways are not perfect and have their disadvantages. Value Observer solves all three problems simply by changing the type to Value Observer, your type. This will add the ability to specify events in the inspector and will automatically monitor for changes to its value. Almost nothing has changed in the inspector. The magic starts when you click the event button. Here we can specify who will listen for event changes and validate the value. Now let's implement the health bar class. Create a bar field for the inner bar that shows the value. Implement the logic to change the displayed value. Another useful thing in the asset is linked observer, which allows you to make a reference to any value observer and use it as if it were a field of that class. Let's add a linked observer that will reference the value in the player controller. Right now we only need this to display the value in the inspector. But a little later we'll use it too. Let's configure the fields in the inspector. Note that you must specify a component, not a game object. As you can see, the field value is displayed and you can change it from here. In addition, you can watch and change the event listeners here. You can easily see if there are listeners by the color of the icon. When the icon is gray, there are no listeners. Otherwise it is yellow. Now let's add a change value listener. As you can see, nothing happened. That's because the event is set to work runtime only. Change it to editor and runtime, and now changing the value causes the UI to update. But there's a problem here, the field accepts any integer value. Let's add value validation. To validate the value, let's make a validate health method that takes a validatable int. And limit the value from 0 to 100. You can have multiple validators for a single field. You only need to assign a value. The observer will know if the value has changed and whether the listeners need to be notified. Expand the validation section and specify a method that will validate the value. Again, this does not work because it is not selected that the event should work in the editor. Now, as you can see, everything works correctly. But who said that health can have a value between 0 and 100? In game settings we have defined that the maximum health is 300. Let's pass this value to the player controller. Normally this is done by passing a reference to an object. But if I only need one field, why do I need the whole object? To pass a reference to an object field, let's create a field of type linked value int and fix the validation method. Select an object and a field in the inspector. Game settings also contain fields of other types, but linked value only shows you the fields of the corresponding types. You can see and change the value here. Okay. The validation method is working well. Now let's update the UI update method. You can use linked value for any serialized properties of any components or scriptable objects. In addition, you can use linked value for built-in Unity classes where the name of the serialized property does not match the name of the field. Linked value is a very versatile tool that will allow you to write code with weak dependencies. I believe you will find a huge number of uses for it in your projects, and it can become your best friend in building good architectures for your scripts. The UI now displays correctly with any maximum health. There is one small thing left to do. I want the current value to be equal to the maximum value at start, Let's add just one line to start. It is important to remember that when you assign a new value, you must use the value property. As you can see, health bar works correctly in editor and in play mode. Now suppose you need to change the value of an observer from another script. In this case, let's pretend it's a slider and not a health bar. In many cases it will be very useful to be able to set a new value for value observer from third-party components. For example, when a character has taken damage or has been healed. Let's implement the behavior of pressing the bar. To set the new value, you just need to assign it to the value property. Then it will be automatically sent to the listeners. The same thing works for linked value. As a result, we have made a very simple code with weak dependencies. This code will be easy to develop and maintain. You will definitely find thousands more ways to use these classes in your projects. This will help improve your code style and make your scripts cleaner and reusable. Thanks for watching. Link to Value Observer in the description.